Hey guys, welcome back. I'm going to do this video. I wasn't going to, but I decided to do it as this is a module for developers, and I think the information you'll find in this video is going to be really helpful for you. And so it's going to be a more in-depth look at Meteor and how to use it in your next project. So it's a tutorial of some sort. And so I'm going to be showing you guys how to use Meteor with React and Flow Router, and I find that there's not too much information out there on this combination of tools, and so it makes sense to give you guys that information. If you are following along this course anyway, I think it's quite reasonable to assume that some of you at least are going to need this information, and even if you didn't know you needed it, maybe you can go ahead and use Meteor in your next project. So in the last video, we created a project through Terminal for Meteor. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to open up my Terminal, and I'm going to change directory into Projects and into To-Do. And so Meteor automatically creates a few files for you first. So let's go ahead and open this up in WebStorm. I'm going to click Open and down into Projects and into To Do. Hit OK. And now WebStorm is going to open up the project. And we've got the project view in the left-hand side. So the first thing we're going to do is delete these files because we don't need them. Now we're going to start creating some directories because in Meteor projects can get fairly large because you're going to be working with a lot of files. And so organization is a huge benefit here. So let's right click and create a directory called client. Going to create another directory called lib and one more for server. Now the client directory is going to contain everything that's going to be available to the client. So this is where your templates and stuff are going to go. So in client, I'm going to create a new directory called components, and this is where we're going to store the React components. Now in lib, what I'm going to do is create a file called router.jsx. And in the router file, we're going to be defining routes for Flow Router. So before we get to that, we actually need to add some packages to the project. So in the directory here in Terminal, just type meteor add React, and then Kadira colon React layout, and Kadira colon flow dash router, and hit enter. There we go. So we've got everything added in here. I was having an issue with JetBrains IDEs, and basically it was a conflict with OpenJDK. And so in order to resolve those, I've installed Oracle Java. And basically what was happening was when you start typing something, this auto suggestion box pops up, and that was causing the program to hang. And so to resolve that, what I had to do was add a repository to my system. And I'm just going to search web update Java. And you're going to go to the launchpad.net page. And in here, just copy this archive URL there. And in Terminal, you can run sudo add apt repository. And then the repository name, and you can actually start connecting multiple commands together. So sudo apt get update. And the way you connect commands together is by using two ampersands between the commands, and that basically says run command 1, and when that's done, if it's successful, run command 2, and if that's done, run the next command, which is going to be sudo apt-get install oracle-java8-installer. And so you're going to run that, and that should resolve the issues with JetBrains IDEs if you're having the same ones as I was. So let's get back to in here. So let's start making some routes.